Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us for our Level 5 Web Application Development Information Evening. I'm Leanne and I work for marketing and I'll be overseeing this event today. And also in the background is my colleague Jasmine, who will be helping me with that. How this webinar will work is our presenters will share their information with you. They can't see you, but you should be able to see them alongside any information they wish to share on screen. Our presenters and other attendees can't hear you. However, you'll be able to ask questions throughout the webinar using the Q&A feature. If you're using a computer, this will be at the bottom of your screen. If you're using a mobile device, tap the screen and this will appear at the top. Someone will either answer your questions live or they'll answer it on the Q&A feed. Ask your questions as we go along and we will save some time at the end to answer as many as we can live. Please be aware that your name will appear next to your question, but you can click Ask Anonymously. We are recording this webinar and you will receive an email with a link to the recording. This will also be available on the Harlow College website. Firstly, we are going to share a short video with you to show you around our campus and introduce you to Harlow College. And also, this includes a message from our principal, Karen Spencer.
Hi, I'm Karen Spencer and I'm the principal at both Harlow College and Stansted Airport College. It's a pleasure to welcome you to our virtual open event. We're really sorry we can't see you in person, but this is an opportunity for you to have a look around and ask some questions. We've got lots of teams talking to you this evening about the fabulous resources and facilities we have here at the college. They're also going to tell you a little bit about why you should choose Harlow College. Please take time to look around, ask questions, and we hope to see you in person in the near future.
Okay, so this evening I'm joined by Kerry, one of our Assistant Academy Managers at Harlow College, Patrick, who is our teacher for the Web Application Development Diploma, and Lee, who is from the Code Institute. So on that note, it's time for me to hand over to Lee to find out what we'll be covering in today's event.
Thanks very much, Leanne. Thank you all, folks, for coming and joining us here this evening to find more about this this program that ourselves and colleagues at Harlow College have put together for you. I've no doubt that some of you here have already possibly been in direct contact with myself and certainly with colleagues if any of you have made a start on the coding challenge, but we'll go into the coding challenge in a little more detail later. First, you've signaled that you're interested in learning how to code through Harlow College and using support and resources that we provide as Code Institute. So this evening is an opportunity for us to put a little bit more meat on the bone in terms of what's involved and what's expected of you as a student. And it's a really good opportunity for you to ask any questions you have. So there is a Q&A feature. Please do make the absolute most of it. You know, rain questions upon us. As has been said, we will answer as many of them as possible during the session. We will go through a short presentation first, where you will have an introduction from Harlow College in terms of who they are and what their mission is and why we're doing this. Then I'll give you some more context as to ourselves at Code Institute, the reason we exist and why learners love learning with us. And then the wider coding industry, why is software development a really valuable skill and what are the potential pathways for you? Then we have a mechanism. So this, the skills that you earn are backed by a regulated qualification, and there is a funding mechanism against that, and we'll talk you through that process. Then Patrick, who's the instructor for this program, he will go into detail on the program content, talk you through what the curriculum looks like, as well as what is expected of you in terms of the types of exciting things that you will build, and then we will get to the questions. So firstly, I would like to introduce Kerry to tell you a little more about Harlow College.
Thank you, Lee. Evening, everyone. I just wanted to start this evening by giving you some reasons why you should obviously join us, Harlow College, in your studies. Firstly, we are graded good by Ofsted. We have won several awards for our innovative approach to learning. We are an Apple Distinguished School. This is the second year in a running. We have excellent employer links. Myself, I work for the business apprenticeship team. So we have a fast pool of employers that we have strong relationships with. Our teaching staff have vast knowledge and experience in this particular industry. We can offer flexible part-time courses for adults with online and blended approach to learning for you to be successful and achieve your course. So I'm going to hand you back over to Lee for the next slide.
Yep, unmuted. Thank you very much, Kerry. So Code Institute, I've no doubt some of you will have done a little bit of digging in terms of who we are and what we do, but in effect, we the reason we exist is to train people to become software developers. We'll see shortly more about the global skills shortage, and even pre-pandemic times, like the software developers have been almost uniformly number one in terms of demand in the digital space. It's a role organizations have been struggling to hire for. So we've been around since 2015. And we've made it really easy for people to reskill in software development. And Patrick will show you the curriculum later. It's very important to stress that even if you have no background in software development whatsoever, the way we've laddered this course, it will bring you from zero knowledge to working proficiency. And the way to assess whether the course is for you and whether you will enjoy the course is through the coding challenge. Why have we been successful? Well, when we thought about, okay, well, organizations are struggling to hire talent. Graduates aren't produced quickly enough. How do we fix that? We spoke to industry partners. You'll see that tile industry led. We work closely with Salesforce, with Accenture, with PayPal, also with startups. And what we look to do with our industry council is we look to build courseware that meets the skill needs that they have. So that means for you as a learner, when you leave one of our programs, you have a set of skills that will resonate with them. And that will put you at the front of the queue whenever they're thinking about the people that they need to hire. All of this is underpinned by a career focus. Everything we do is geared around, you know, getting you the job at the end of the program. And the assessment for this, it's not theoretical. It's you learn by doing. So you build a series of projects, four in total across the program. And these projects make up your portfolio. And that portfolio is the story of you. So we teach you skills that employers want. We equip you with a portfolio that represents you and the skills that you can offer to employers. And that's what you use in an interview to show to an employer what you can do, the creativity you have, the problem-solving ability that you have. And to get you to that interview, that's the key with the qualification. So you have the qualification that helps you navigate the job market and get you into that interview so that you can nail the job. We'll just look at the next slide in terms of the job market and the navigating of that job market with your qualifications. So the global skills shortage is something that has been exacerbated in the past 12 months. So since COVID has happened, There's been huge displacement in terms of employment. I'm not sure how any of you may have been personally impacted or not, but digital tools have been, if anything, amplified. We're using this fantastic medium here to communicate this evening. Microsoft, at the end of the summer in August, they did an analysis of the workforce globally. They estimate 150 million new jobs will be created between now and 2025. Of that 150 million jobs, 98 million of them will be in software development. So the scale of the opportunity on a global level is absolutely huge in terms of employability. And that also relates to a local level at the UK. And you can look at the data on this. The data you see there on the screen is around the World Economic Forum. So I can't remember what the next slide is, actually. I can't see the agenda. Kerry, it's back to you.
Thanks, Lee. I just wanted to introduce myself correctly, along with Patrick. Again, my name is Kerry Sim. I'm the Assistant Academy Manager for Business Apprenticeships, which involves and includes part-time adult courses. I've worked here at the college now for nearly 10 years. I am a qualified assessor, IQA, and teacher myself. But my role is to support Patrick in his delivery and his planning of the course. And obviously, you will be given my details. So if you've got any questions for me, and if I can support you in any way, you will be able to do so. Patrick's full name is Patrick Justice. He will be your teacher for the Level 5 Web Application Development course. Patrick is also a qualified assessor, IQA, teacher with over 30 years of experience in the industry and as a teacher. So you're in safe hands with Patrick. So I'm going to hand you back over to Lee for the next slide.
Linking back to what I said previously in terms of the employment opportunity. So we have a global skill shortage. You have a national skill shortage in the UK in terms of the number of jobs that are available and organizations really struggling to fill these roles. That means that they heavily incentivize people to fill those roles. They even hiring internationally, they offer bounties for people to relocate. But the implication of it is that progression routes are fast and that salaries are attractive. Now, when I speak to learners that have learned with us and have been with Code Institute since 2017, there's a variety of different reasons why people end up valuing the program or end up valuing the career pathway. Perhaps at the outset, the attraction is because of the number of jobs that are available. Perhaps the attraction is because software development traditionally has been quite a flexible job where you work on a more project focused basis rather than a traditional 9-to-5 basis. But yes, the progression routes are quick. Within 3 years, you can be at senior level, usually around 3 to 4 years. And the salary escalation is good. But for a lot of people, it comes down to meaning as well. The scope and the job opportunities out there. I mean, if you're someone that's passionate about education, you can find a job as a developer within the education sector, within sports, within medicine. There's almost every single sector is open to you. And then beyond that, it could be a case that you have an idea. A really good idea for a product or service that you want to build and implement. It could even be something as simple as a website for someone you know who has a business. This program will give you the skills you need to know in order to be able to do that. So that's really, I suppose, the main reasons why people choose to learn this program. I'll now introduce Patrick to talk a little bit more about the structure of the course.
Okay, hello, good evening, everybody. Thanks, Lee, for that introduction. Basically, talking about the skills you gain, you know, to be able to become a web application developer, there are, for this particular unit, we have a course, we have four different units that you're going to learn to help you with this. And as you can see from the image, they're grouped into three main sections. You would have the front end, which is what the users will see or the world will see. And then we have the back end, which is, data that is in motion, which is not seen by people, but it's in the background helping with, the software itself. and then the data in the base, which is the actual data that is, you know, that is stored in there. So it, interactively, the data in the base, you know, handled by the back engine, it's, you know, then thrown to the front. So if you like, at the end of the day, you would, you know, you'll be able to have, you know, have gained knowledge to develop what is referred to as a full stack development. Okay. So next slide on this, you know, what will be the content, you know, as you can see on the screen here, we have quite a variety of courses. Like I said before, there'll be four main units. Initially, you know, you would have, you know, you'd have learned some coding fundamentals of various types, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, Python. You know, all of these are tools that will be used in the course itself. The course, like I said, have four main units. So we have unit one, which is a user-centric front end. Then we have unit two, which is interactive front end development. The unit three is the data-centric development. And the fourth one is the full stack. And that is a level six in itself. So we have three level, the first level unit one, two, and three are level five. And the fourth one, full stack development using Django, you know, is actually a level six. So the two level, unit one and unit two, as you can see, the name is talked about front end. So that will be used, you know, to develop the front end, what the users will see on the website. And it will comprise things like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, you know, that would help with the development of the front end. So you would learn quite different, you know, varieties of codes that will guide you to be able to do that. And then at the back engine, so whilst this unit one and unit two are for the front end, you know, view of a software developed, the data centric, okay, will be at the back engine. And what it does there is there are the main thing that will be at the back is the database itself. So you will learn how to design a database, how to handle database, how to design the database and create relationships between data depending on how complex the system is. You know, so that such data can now be tied in with what is referred to as MySQL. There are other tools like Mango tools and Python. These are tools that you can use. There's also things like PHP, which can also be used in managing the data at the back, at the back engine. Okay, so that you will learn. And then to complete the course itself and give you that flavor, we have the full to have the full stack using the Django. So that would become the main big project that you would do. However, for each of the units, one, two, three, and four, you know, you would be assessed on those using, you know, projects. And the fourth one is the main big project that ties everything together. Next slide, please. So here, like I was saying about how you're going to learn, you know, it's going to be blended to start with, where you would have 3.5 or 3 hours per week in the evenings on a particular day of the week, you know, where you would work with me and I'll guide you through the various workshops and how things are going to be done, you know, giving you a one-to-one assistance and facilitation. And then, you know, using the software base that you know that is managed by Code Institute, from which you know you will see a variety of portfolios, which will, again will be personalized or you know individualized, you know, so that it's going to be self-paced, and you go through a timeline as you progress on the course itself. Next slide, please. So how would we support you at Harlow College? You know, we're going to go through when you join the course, having enrolled on the course, there will be a program induction where you would come to know about what we do in the college, and there will be an induction going through the, if you like, the housekeeping, the things that needs to be done on the course, what you expect from me and the college as a student, and also you will learn to know what we expect of you as a student. So you know, you will see the platforms that we're going to be using, all the hardware and software will be introduced, the workshop that we'll be having, which is going to be more of hands-on. And then you're going to also go through the assessment, which I mentioned before. It's going to be a portfolio of assessments on each of the four units that make up the course itself. And you have opportunity to have feedbacks, you know, instantly. And also, but, you know, towards the end of every unit, you would also have feedbacks. And when all of these four main areas are, you know, the workshop, assessment, and feedback happens, you will ultimately be able to achieve your diploma at the end of the day. Next slide. So this should be Lee now.
Wonderful. I've mastered the art of unmuting. So thank you, Patrick. So folks, you have the fantastic support of Patrick and the team delivering the program to you from Harlow College, and the sessions where Patrick will bring you through the program and coach you and give you guidance and mentoring in terms of the projects and your progress. And you'll work together as a group in, you know, a really, really good participatory learning experience. But ourselves, Code Institute, I'm sure some of you have looked into what we do. You've seen a couple of snapshots of the platform. So we're incredibly proud of our learning system. We've invested a lot of time, energy, and effort into making it a really, really great place to learn. So when you log on to that platform, our student care team are the first people. They're all like, they are your guide. So when you're talking to them, they'll ask you about your circumstances. You'll say, I'm a student of Harlow College. So you'll be given a schedule. You'll have a set schedule, and you student care will set goals for you. They'll also show you how to use the platform and to access these other supports. They will give you guidance in terms of how you engage with those other supports in an effective way. And it's really important whenever you register to the program that you have your initial call with the student care team, because it will make the rest of your journey so much more seamless. As you're learning, and in instances where you're not in sessions with Patrick, and I think it's important to mention that the sessions with Patrick, outside of that, you will be expected approximately 12 hours per week on top of the college sessions in order to successfully achieve this program within the 12 months. That's something that you honestly have to reckon with yourself. But we have this support to help push you through the program. So the tutoring team are available on a 24-hour basis from Monday through Friday. So let's say, for instance, you're working through the program. There's a concept in one of the videos that you don't quite understand. You're typing your code and it won't work in the right way. You can push a button, talk to tutoring, and they will give you guidance in terms of the best way to tackle that problem. You will also have an individual mentor. So our mentors are folk that work for the likes of your Salesforces, PayPals. They also work for startups. They're senior developers with several years of experience under their belts. Their role is the projects you're assessed on. They guide you. You may have the best idea in the world for your final project and think, I'm going to build Amazon, but you're time bound. So they will tell you, well, that's not realistic or achievable, but it's a good idea. Let's try this bit of it, and that will meet the brief. So they help you plan your things effectively, and they also give you feedback in terms of whether the work you create is of a professional standard or not. Then there's the community, and I would encourage all of you, when you're on the program, engage with the community. It will make it a much, much richer experience. You will have your own Harlow College group on our student community, but you will also have the ability to engage with all of our other learners internationally. That means you can share your wins, share your frustrations when things aren't working your way, show off the work that you've built, and help each other as you go through the program. Really makes it a much more fruitful learning experience. And I know a question has come in around career, so I won't spend too long on this specific piece. We'll perhaps talk about it a little bit more at the end, but we have a lady, Jane Gormley, that heads up career development. We deal with a lot of career changers, people who perhaps have not gone through a formal interview process before. What we do within careers is we help you build your digital persona. We help you build your CV. We help you build your LinkedIn profile. We help you put your portfolio together in an effective way on GitHub. And then the whole piece about that interview and nailing the interview, we need to make sure that you're able to do a screening interview, that you, when someone who is a senior developer talks to you about your coding skills, that you're able to negotiate that so you can role play those with our mentors. And that's something that we provide for candidates that you don't really get anywhere else, is the expertise in the technical interview. Outside of that, with Careers, every Thursday we have a Careers webinar where employers come and talk about the work culture in their organizations, giving you insights in terms of the best ways to apply and what their processes are. On Friday afternoons, Jane and the team have an open clinic where you can go and ask them questions, get coaching and guidance. Our mission with Careers is we give you the core skills through the curriculum and through the teaching. The career skills is giving you the soft skills so that you're able to convey to a prospective employer what you can do and to put you in the strongest possible position in an interview. So I think the next slide is career development. So actually I've gone through quite a good bit of the career development there. So we can move to the application process with Kerry.
Thank you, Leigh. Before I go through the application process, I firstly want to discuss with you about how do you fund the course. There is a course fee. It's $5,400. Like any career change, it will require an investment of your time and money. But you may be eligible for an advanced learner loan, which can be used to pay part of it, or will literally pay the full amount. The requirements is you've got to be 19 and over. But what will happen is when you go through the application process, us Harlow College will send you all the information that you would need about the advanced learner loan, the link to the application to fill in for that loan. And then you can process that, and you wouldn't have to pay that back until you complete the course. Or you're earning, I think it's $26,725 or more until you actually have to pay that, start paying that loan back. Next slide, please. So just a run through of obviously the schedule of this course, like when you start, duration. So the start of the course is this April. We commence in the 12th. Your first session will be that Thursday, which will be the 19th. The session will be from 5:30 to 8:30. And Patrick will send you all the information that you will need to join that class. The class will be via Teams unless Patrick decides otherwise. The course is for 52 weeks, but you must bear in mind that we have to take away a Christmas, Easter, and a short summer break, obviously because teachers take annual leave. As Lee said previously, it is a minimum of 12 hours per week, so you need to dedicate that amount of time, obviously, and the 3 hours with Patrick on a Thursday. Patrick will help and will make a realistic plan with you. He'll be able to support you, set goals for you to be successful and achieve the course. And like I said previously, it's a very flexible approach to learning. So obviously I understand some may already be in work. So this will obviously really help those that are obviously in employment already. Next slide, please. So the application progress, I'm gonna start to end, because I know some of you that are joining this evening have already at certain stages, and I've already spoke to you via email. So the first stage, for those that haven't done it, would be you go onto our website, www.harlow-college.ac.uk, and you will complete an expression of interest form. Not an application, it's just an expression of interest. Once we've received that will have your name and contact details. We will pass it over to the Code of Institute, and then they will obviously contact you with details of completing the coding challenge. Completing this coding challenge is important because this is make you viable for entry of the course. And then the Code of Institute will inform us that you've completed that coding challenge. Once they've informed us, we will then, from our admissions team, we'll send you a link to fill in the full application. Also along with any information about the advanced learner loan and any other additional information admissions field that to tell you. Once you've completed that application form, we will get a notification that you've completed that. And then once you've completed that application, we will contact you and arrange an interview. And that interview will be conducted by Patrick for you to get to know Patrick. And he will be the one to say, yes, you're approved, you will move forward. And then obviously he will give you start dates and any information that requires from him for you to start smoothly. I think the next slide is Lee, that I'm going to pass you on to.
Magic, we're getting good at this, Kerry. So thank you very much. So as Kerry mentioned, she talked you through the application process there. I'm looking forward to getting to the questions. Thank you. There's a bunch of them coming through, and keep them coming. So the five-step coding challenge is part of the admissions process. So you signify your interest in doing this program to Harlow College. That alerts us. We send you login information to the challenge. The challenge itself is designed, it gives you access to our learning platform. So it ticks boxes on both sides. For us and for Harlow College, it reassures us that you know what you are engaging with, that you know what software development is, and that you're comfortable with approaching the subject and that you're able to do the subject. From your own perspective, it should show you how information is presented and the type of activities that will be expected of you on the program. So as you're doing it, we really hope that you love it and you think, wow, this is amazing. I want to go ahead with this. And we're quite confident that the majority of the time that is the case. The challenge is a really, really great thing. Within a few short steps, it only takes a few hours, you get to build your first web page. You can see there, it's a recipe for how to make a cup of tea. Crucial information in my world, but you can customize that and make it anything you want, a burger recipe, a cocktail recipe. The content you can customize, but if you follow it through, you'll have the recipe for making a cup of tea. And I think Jasmine has just shared the link to the coding challenge. Encourage all of you to open it now. And if you haven't already been enrolled to the coding challenge, please sign up to it there. You may see other ways of doing the coding challenge through Code Institute, but for applying to Harlow, you need to use this link. That's a very, very important piece, because that way we will be able to track your application effectively. So please do follow that. Anyhow, Kerry, I will pass it over to you for a recap, and then perhaps we can move on to questions.
Yep. Thank you, Lee. Just a recap of what we've just said. So you will achieve a series of projects to show off your ability and for your successful completion of the course. You will also gain a set of skills relevant to industry. You will receive support from both Code Institute and ourselves, Harlow College. It is a flexible learning approach, so it meets everyone's needs and requirements. You will also be able to apply for advanced learner loan for the fee. And I really, really hope that we've given you enough information to make you want to study the course with us at Harlow College. So what I'm going to do now is Lee and Patrick and myself are all here. I'm going to go live and see some of the questions that you've asked and see if between the three of us we can answer them. So the first one, if I can't answer them, I will pass them over to Lee and Patrick. The first one, do I need to attend Harlow College face-to-face teaching since I live in Kent? No, that you do not have to attend campus. All the sessions with Patrick will be online remotely on a Thursday. Doesn't mean that you can't attend, come visit us at the campus, but no, you can come onto the course and it will be remote no matter where you live. Next one, Someone's asked if it's 3 hours per week or a one-off. No, it's 3 hours per week. So it's every Thursday for 3 hours. We recommend you attend every week, so you stay on top of your studies and you complete those deadlines and goals that you have set with your, with Patrick, the tutor. Sorry, I'm going to the next one. I've completed the challenge almost 2 weeks ago. I haven't heard anything back from Harlow College. How do I get in touch directly? I've got all your names and details now from the Coding Institute, who's passed that coding challenge. And as of Monday, we will be in touch for those with links to applications and preparing and setting up interviews. Sorry, Patrick and Lee, I'm answering all of them.
Yeah, that's fine.
Look, absolutely. Not, like, Kerry, this is great. I might make a cup of tea.
I don't know if you can answer this one. I started to study IT engineering, but I failed because a lot of maths and physics. How is the maths level at CI?
Yeah, I can take that. So
yeah, thank you.
Yeah, it's so. I suppose historically there has been a perception that you need to be good, or you need to have a background in maths or science. You can't have no maths. So that basic numeracy is, you know, so you like in terms of your basic multiplication, division. So I would say a basic level of maths. The style of learning on this program is more like language learning. You learn through repetition, consistency, commitment. That's how you acquire fluency. I really would not have a previous experience in a science or maths-based study or program deter you from engaging with software development, because this is a different discipline. Hopefully, if you engage with the challenge, you will see that. But in the program at large, that's our philosophy. You need numeracy, you need literacy, and you need a good understanding of English. But most importantly, you need to have motivation, grit and self-determination in order to succeed. Those are really the key ingredients, and problem-solving ability.
Thank you, Lee. Next one is, what type of computer would I need? That's a valid question.
Yeah.
It's a valid question. Patrick, would you like to take this one?
Yeah, okay, fair enough. Almost all computers, you know, that we have now, you know, within the last 3 to 4 years should be sufficient. If you have, good hard disk and memory on a computer, Windows-based, I would say, not quite familiar with, although you can also use Mac, so any computer that is able to, you know, go online and that has, able to access internet, that has Wi-Fi and all those, yeah. All right.
Thank you, Patrick. Another one. I've done my coding challenge. Do I need to do it again? No, you don't. If you've already previously done it with the Coding Institute, regardless of going through the expression of interest on our website, Lee has informed me of those that have previously taken it, and I have that information also.
Yeah, I would just add to that, Kerry. So there are instances, people may have multiple email addresses. So if it's a case that you've applied to Harlow College using a separate email, but you know that you've completed it before, you can query it with Kerry. She can then bounce it back to myself and I can check. So, but you know, if there's the potential for a second email to have been used, do share that so that we can check it against the records. If you've already done it, we'll say, look, that's a pass. By all means, we recommend.
Yeah. Thank you, Lee. Next one. I'm studying BTEC Level 3 Extended Diploma in IT. We'll be finishing the course in July. Will I be able to join in April intake with Harlow College? You can't be funded or be doing two courses at the same time. So unfortunately, you will have to wait until you've completed and achieved your extended diploma in IT, and then obviously apply for our course. You can't be doing two at the same time because there's a fund due to funding. Sorry, next one. Can you I think this one might be for you, Liv, at Coding Challenge. It says, can you resubmit if you don't get the grades you want? Is that, I'm not sure if that's regarding the Coding Challenge. Let's base it on the Coding Challenge.
Yes, so for the Coding Challenge, absolutely you can. So, you go through it, you go back. You know, one of the things with the Coding Challenge, you saw all the wonderful supports that we layer in around. So the only thing you're really using when you're on the Coding Challenge is the LMS. We give you some recommendations for external sources that you can use for guidance, but you're not availing of tutoring, you're not availing of mentoring. The Coding Challenge is your opportunity to demonstrate to us and to Harlow College that you have the capacity to take on the program, that you have problem-solving ability, and you have that little bit of resourcefulness. By all means, if at first you don't succeed, try again. In terms of resubmissions for the main projects on program, that would be within the assessment guidance that Harlow College give to you.
Thank you, Lee.
Thank you.
This might be one for you, Lee, because obviously this is our first time of doing the course, so you've had a lot more experience with cohorts. It's a question: how long does it typically take a graduate to find a job once completing the course in your experience?
So we have people that have, and it was a source of frustration for us, we have people that have completed the first legs of the course and then found jobs before finishing, which is its own piece. But no, typically we measure within 6 months in all seriousness. So I mentioned Jane and her team earlier. So before Jane joined, we had 88% within 6 months. I was at a session last week where, you know, we're not seeing each other face to face. So we had a company-wide update. We're at 90% at the moment, and her team is growing. So their ambition is to bring that up to 95 in a year's time. But it has always been very, very strong. The demand is there from employers. We give the skills. So you would look at approximately a 6 month window. And we will help you out with that process.
Thank you, Lee. A few more left. Obviously someone's mentioned, is it not all online? Yes, it is all online. The delivery from Patrick will be a remote session as well, online, and obviously all the work that you will be doing, you'll be self-studying it and uploading to the portfolio. Someone's asked for the next intake. We're looking at a next intake for September.
Yep.
And then Patrick or Lee might want to take these. Are there many opportunities for junior software developers?
Yes, okay, let me take that. Yeah, most definitely. Once you're on the course, in fact, my advice will be, as you join the course, you should get yourself registered with some of these agencies, you know, and so you could begin to see, and even during the course, you will see a variety of openings that are in industry. And as you build your CV in tandem, you can apply to these jobs. And, obviously I don't see a reason why you cannot get the job. You know, it's all depends on maybe interview skills. But again, the Coding Institute have the career support that will guide you towards, preparing yourself, being prepared for interviews and creating your portfolios and CVs, okay?
Okay. Yes. Thank you. I'm just very mindful of the time because it's 6:45. I'm going to do one more question, but then we will stay on and answer them afterwards. One more question live. On the actual models of the course, Can you resubmit if you fail or get a low grade? Inexperienced Lee?
So Harlow College, you guys will have your own assessment guidance. Typically, what I can speak to is you do get a chance to resubmit. So if you fail a module, you will get an opportunity to resubmit. You will be capped at a pass. So this award is tiered. You can get a distinction, you can get a merit, or you can get a pass. And in each of the projects that you submit, they are graded on those tiers, distinction, merit, pass. But if you fail, you get a chance to resubmit, and it is limited to a pass for that module. So that's the way that would be structured.
Thank you, Lee. So I'm gonna close the live Q&A for the moment, because I'm just looking at the time. So if I pass you back over to Leanne, but please, any more questions, still type them in and we'll answer them.
Thank you so much, everyone, for answering all those questions. Thank you to all of our attendees for asking those questions as well. You definitely kept our tutors and Lee on their toes through that session. That was great. Before we draw this to a close, we would now like to ask you a couple of questions. We're going to do a couple of polls, and the first one should appear on your screen now. These polls are completely anonymous, so please get involved. And we will give you about 30 seconds to answer this first poll. We just want to know how helpful you found this session today. Lovely. We'll just give you a few more seconds to answer that. And then we'll move on to our second poll. That's great stuff. Thank you, everyone. We'll move on to our second poll. That should be on your screen now. Like I said before, it's completely anonymous, so please get involved. And we just want to know how likely you are to apply for this fantastic course after hearing from these guys today. We'll give you a few more seconds to answer that. Lovely. Thank you very much. Thank you for that. Okay, thank you everyone for joining us today. We hope you got a lot out of this evening's information event. If you would like any more information about this great course, you can go onto our website, www.harlow-college.ac.uk. You can search web application development and that will come up in the search top result. Click it and all the information will be there. We will drop you an email with the session recording, and we would really appreciate it if you could spend a couple of minutes filling out our quick survey so we can continue to improve this service. We are going to keep this session open for a little bit longer, just in case you had any more burning questions you want to ask our tutors, and they can quickly answer all the questions that are on that Q&A feature that haven't been answered already. But thank you very much, and we hope you enjoy the rest of your evening.